Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at using font panel favorites. Now, if you use fonts in apps, you probably know there are different ways to set up styles as defaults and things you can use again. I'm going to create a new pages document here, and you can see here I've got the format sidebar on and I can change fonts, set character styles. But there's a way to do this that's cross-application. So it not only works in pages but other places as well. So let me show you here. I'm going to select the word test, and instead of using this I am going to go to Format, Font, and Show Fonts. Command T is the universal shortcut for this, and it brings up something called the Fonts panel here. We can use this Fonts panel here to select a font, and it will change it here for what we have selected. So I can select the font and then a variation, like there's a bolded variation of this particular font, and different fonts have, some have few variations, some have many. This has a whole bunch of different ones here, and we can change it, we can change the size and all of that. Now if there's something that we're going to be reusing, using a lot, not just in pages but in other applications as well, we can save that as a favorite. The way to do that is to click the Tools button here and Add to Favorites. Now if we select the Favorites collection here, we'll see it's been added and it's been named the name of the font and the style and then also the point size. And we can do that with other fonts as well. So for instance, let's go ahead and select another font here, another size, another style, and we'll add that also. And now we see we have two here in favorites. I have this text still selected and I can very quickly jump between these by simply selecting them here. Now the great thing about using these favorites here is they work in other applications. So for instance, let's switch to text edit, and here I am in text edit and I have a rich text document, and I can also bring up the fonts panel and I can type something and select it, and you can see I can use the same panel here and my favorites even show up even though I'm using another application. The same thing is also true even in mail. I could be composing a new message here and I can also bring up the fonts panel with Command T, and they're my favorites here. So I can create these favorites in any app using this fonts panel, and then I can access the favorites very easily anywhere I want. Now in addition to setting some of the basics here, you can even do things like setting the color. So let's select some text here and I can change the color of this, and then once I do that I can add to the favorites, and you can see I have another version here that's a different color, and I could switch between them, but notice the color doesn't reflect over there. And I find that it's kind of hit or miss. Sometimes colors selected from the fonts panel work and sometimes they don't. Now deleting these favorites here can be a little bit tricky. If you simply alter one, you can add a new favorite and you get a second copy of it. But if you want to get rid of it, you think that hitting the delete key will work. That won't. I'll actually delete over here. The way to do it is to drag out and then it goes away. You could also add more collections here. So you've got favorites and it's easy to add to favorites thanks to this command right here. But you can also create a collection, call it whatever you want, and then you can drag and drop here. So you can go into your favorites and you can drag one in here. It will still be in favorites because it's still favorited, but you'll see it also there. So you can kind of create your own collections. The ones you see here actually correspond to groups of fonts that you've got. So for instance, modern fonts or traditional fonts, and you'll see them here. But these that you create are kind of like favorites in that you can set a particular style. You can also double click on these and rename them. So if there's something in particular, like a style that your company uses for correspondence or for headings, you can name it that and then have easy access to knowing which one to use. Now in addition to creating favorite fonts, the full collection of style and size, you can also create your favorite sizes over here. So you've got this command where you can do edit sizes, and instead of using this default set, say for work you do, you're always using font size 20, you can actually add that new size in there and then it will appear there and you don't have to enter it manually every time. Because you can enter it manually right there, but sometimes it's nice to actually have it here and be able to select it.